My name is Toby Francis Logston, and this is who I am. A man with so much enthusiasm and frustration.
Bank!
With interests of intrigue and wonder. With secrets and curiosities. With family and friends. With love and heartbreak. With one condition. My condition, the condition I was born with, and the condition I live with. However, this does beg the question, is this really living? Sure, I get up, get ready for the day ahead. I go to college, volunteering, or participate in my sport. But no matter where I go, I am surrounded by people who talk endlessly about things in their lives, such as relationships and work, what they got up to last weekend, or even what they got up to last night, having a wonderful time with each other. And it's like, I'm not there. You see, I am autistic. I know it, and they know it. And they think they understand. Wrong.
Trying to understand this condition is like trying to understand another language.
Well, don't worry. Let me translate it for you.
We live in a world where we are ever more accepting and accommodating to various different parts of our society, whether it be gender, racial, or LGBT equality. But there are still some those who struggle to accommodate these various different aspects of society, and even worse, try to abolish them or change them because of their behaviour. It's not that they don't think it's not normal, but it's just because they don't quite understand where they're coming from. And autism is no exception to this. I should know. I suffer from it.
I've never met anybody in my life who was against my condition, but I have come across many individuals in my life who treat me or regard me in a certain way because they don't quite get the challenges of my condition or how I perceive the world or even how I process information. If they did, they would see me for who I am, and more than likely, they would then treat me in a different way to how they currently treat me. It's not like they are out to make my life difficult, but that is how I feel though. And I think that their lives and my life would be a whole lot easier if each side were to understand each other more truthfully and more tangibly, to see beyond what they perceive just by casual observation. I think it's because most people don't consider me or my behaviour as normal. But is there really such a thing as normal?
I think that normal is very subjective. Your normal is different from my normal. Life would be very boring if everybody was the same. And what is normal? There is no such thing as normal. It's a spectrum, and everybody, life is a spectrum, and everybody is on that spectrum somewhere.
I don't think there is such a thing as normal. I think every single person is different. Everybody has different views, different ideas, different skills, different attributes. And I don't think that there is any way that we should be matching autistic people against normal people. I believe that we should understand that each individual is an individual. And there's who's to say that non-autistic people fall under the banner of normal? I don't think there's such a thing.
A lot of the time, so-called normal people try to be humble. They think a lot of thoughts about things, but they never actually say them out loud. Whilst autistic people would just come out and say it as it is. Honest to good honesty. Though one of the downfalls with some people that have autism is that they can't handle multiple tasks at once. Especially if they're challenging tasks, and they can get stressed in various different kinds of ways. That is usually when so-called normal people should give us some extra slack, because they do not understand fully what is going through our heads. But we know it's the price that we pay and accept. However, it is the challenges that people sometimes find intriguing. For example, a lot of autistic people do actually go out and achieve great things when they actually get the chance to do so. It is when people understand that with our condition and all the challenges that come with it under the surface, these achievements can be all the more remarkable.
Courtney Love is on the autistic spectrum. I know Daryl Hannah is. Tim Burton. There's some research that's been done into quite famous people like Isaac Newton and Mozart to suggest that they may have been on the autistic spectrum. Also Lewis Carroll, who wrote Alice in Wonderland. And also people, there's some question that maybe Vladimir Putin might be on the autistic spectrum.
Something I would like to make clear about my condition is that despite all of the sympathetic issues that come with it, autism is not a get-out-of-jail-free card. There are consequences to my actions, and I face up to them like everyone else does, no matter how unintentional or insensitive it might be. It's not like I set out to make regrettable decisions or to say inappropriate sentences at the wrong place at the wrong time, but to be honest, there shouldn't be any shame in that. Everyone in their lives makes silly mistakes, even so-called normal people. All we can do is just to do our best to never make the same mistakes again and continue to move forward.
Sometimes, yeah, because they might, I don't know, ask questions that other people might not ask or whatnot, which I suppose is a good thing and sometimes a bad thing, but yeah.
One of my favourite movies of all time is Cool Runnings. The story of how the first Jamaican bobsled team overcame every kind of prejudice you can think of so that they could make it to the Winter Olympics. There are a lot of moral messages in that movie as well. Messages about being yourself without being ashamed. Messages about standing up for yourself.
I see a badass mother who don't take no crap of nobody.
But the most impactful message that I got is a message that really doesn't impact my condition, but more, it illustrates it.
We're different. People are always afraid of what's different.
Harsh but true. An enlightening but natural revelation. And maybe why so many people in my life who don't fully understand my condition have treated me in such a judgmental way. Because they think I'm different. Yes, I am different, but yet so is everyone else. That doesn't automatically make me less valuable or inferior.
Applied behavioural analysis is a form of education designed to help retrain autistic people so that they can better function in the real world. It is a technique that aims to alter autistic people's behaviour whilst undertaking simple day-to-day activities through the use of repetition. Autistic people are creatures of habit, so by practicing doing the same thing over and over again, it should be implanted into their behavioural patterns, like muscle memory. This education technique is taught in hundreds of specialist schools all over the United States of America, whilst here in the UK, things are handled a little differently.
It's my view that it's a mistake to try and train autistic people to be normal just because they're different. It's better for them to embrace the talents that the individual has. And down this driveway lies a specialist private school called LVS Hassox, who specialise in educating young autistic people in just this way. I volunteered here for a short time.
Whilst people both inside and out of this school have different opinions about how autistic people should be handled in education, At the very least, the people down this driveway are striving to provide ways of educating autistic children to help them best function in the real world and how to teach them the functional skills that they need.
From my own experience, we were extremely lucky. Our son was statemented at school all through his education, and therefore he had all the support he needed to deal with mainstream education. But unfortunately, it's a cost thing, and it's whether the schools around the areas have enough money to be able to sustain and keep a special needs teacher or support within mainstream education. And it really is the luck of the draw. I was very lucky with our son that he was, but there are people that don't get enough support. So if they want more children with special needs to go to mainstream schools and be educated in mainstream schools, they need to step up the amount of support that they get at school.
It's a real bugbear for me because my son, my stepson is 13. He was in a mainstream school and they were excluding him, saying he was attention seeking. And this went on for about a year. It got to a stage where he was excluded 36 days out of 37. Every time he went back in, he lasted an hour and he was excluded again. And the things that would set him off would be quite normal things, like they would have a music lesson and there would be drumming and he can't cope with loud noise. If they pinpoint him as an individual in a group setting, he doesn't like the attention, that would be enough to set him off. I think mainstream schools really don't understand autism. I mean, we had to take him out of school. He wasn't in a school setting for 90 days because where they were trying to put him was behavioural units for children that were just off the rails and couldn't cope. Whereas his wasn't behavioural, as we found out later, he's autistic, so things are different for him. We're very lucky that he's now at a specialist school, which is very autism-led, and they rely on therapy. And he's not excluded ever, settled, calm. But the price on that is it's a private school. So we have to battle with funding all the time.
There are 25 million autistic people in the world. That's nearly half the population of people in the United Kingdom alone. In the UK, only 14% of all autistic adults are in full-time employment, and that's the lowest amount for anyone who has a notable disability. This is very unfortunate, because I have met quite a few autistic people who have such remarkable gifts, talents, and skills, which they pride themselves in because of their condition. And I think to myself, they should go to work for this or that. They would be really good at working for this or that. But how can they when the rest of humanity is holding them back? Not in a harsh way, but in a cautious way, fueled by a lack of understanding. Scope is a collection of different charity shops across the country, who more often than not employ people who are on the autistic spectrum to work at their various different stores. This one, located in Haywards Heath, is one that I previously worked in. All the staff here have their own unique opinions about the employment of autistic people and how they should be treated in the workplace.
I'm the shop manager for Scope in Haywards Heath. It's a charity shop, and the proceeds from the shop go towards the charity, and Scope exists to make the world a better place for disabled people, or the country a better place for disabled people and their families. And at the moment there's a big initiative in Scope to make the workplace better for disabled people and to give disabled people access, better access to the workplace and for employment.
Well, my role is I'm a van driver. So basically what I do is I go to textile banks, collect textiles, bring them into the shops for them to sort through and then sell them on. And the idea with Scope is that they're making as much money as they can for good causes, mainly disabilities, either mental health or physical disabilities. Everything I bring in the shop is pure profit. So whether it goes to reg or they sell it on to customers.
Working for SCORP, we do deal with them on a daily basis. I have a lot of volunteers who have mild autism, quite severe autism. So working with those, just helping them come out of the shell, communicate better, just developing relationships, friendships with them is really beneficial to them and to us as well as so-called normal people, getting to see how and what these people have to deal with daily basis.
Lots of our volunteers at Scope have social communication disorder or autism or Asperger's, and we do our best to accommodate everybody. We expect the same from everybody. We have very high expectations, but we like to see the potential in people and give them every opportunity. Sometimes it can be a bit challenging. The situation is a bit challenging. Customers can be unpredictable. You can have loud noises in the shop. You can have children in the shop. But we do our best to give everybody the same opportunities. So we would expect people to work on the till, but we would expect people to work back of house. The majority of people with autism could strive out into the world, but I think, as I said before, adaptions need to be made. I think there has to be a greater amount of education within the wider world, that people with autism are not scary, they're not dangerous, they're not freaky, all of which I've had said to me about people that I've come into contact with. I think, again, it's having the right support and the right network in place to ensure that everybody is well provided for and well supported within communities.
I find it remarkable how the Americans make such an effort to try and change what autistic people are, and yet some of the biggest contributions in major tech conglomerates such as Google, Apple, NASA, and indeed Microsoft, who have an entire special division dedicated to try and help autistic people flourish in their respective industries, are now creating state-of-the-art software which is used by millions of people all over the world. And these contributions have been made by somebody who is, in one way or another, on the autistic spectrum. Whilst here in the UK, it's the other way around. You have these prestigious, well-meaning autistic schools like LVS Hassocks and LVS Oxford, who make such an effort to try and educate young autistic people to not only function in the real world, but also to help them be better people by embracing the positive gifts that they have.
Yeah, I mean, it depends what interests they're in, like anyone really. I know my friend was, you know, he was really creative and he was into similar interests like me, like films, games, books, that sort of thing. So he had that kind of creative aspect to him. But I think like anyone, it depends on other people around them. What's the word? Giving them enough support to make them feel comfortable with that sort of creativity and to make them feel comfortable within themselves to work with this sort of gift, if you want to call it that.
Sometimes I walk up to a group of friends and all I'm doing is just acting with the best intentions, trying to be a decent person and trying to be myself. And for some reason, oblivious to me, good or bad, they look at me or speak to me in a tone of voice with a slight hint, a subtle hint of apprehension towards me. Like it's off-putting to have someone like me in this situation which they are comfortable without me. I have seen this with so many people, and there is always a sense of doubt that I pick up on. A tiny facial movement, a slight change in tone of voice, which causes me to overthink the situation and presume the worst, whether this is their true intention or not underneath the surface. which isn't helped by the occasional difficulties that I have when it comes to communicating with so-called normal people, as they don't understand where I'm coming from with my condition. Happily, most of the time with people that I know, this isn't anything worth worrying about, and my reaction can mainly stem from me not wanting to lose any of my friends. But it's something that is never made totally clear to me in the moment that can come from my concern at the time. And it is most certainly one of the social anxieties I struggle with that comes from my condition.
Whilst there are many aspects to my autism that make it difficult for me to manage parts of normal daily life, which so-called normal people find so easy, there are many things I'm able to manage to far greater success than so-called normal people can achieve. But it's not necessarily an advantage to people who do have autism, as in life, there are many things that many people are able to do better than others, whether you're autistic or otherwise.
Sometimes, people can be uncomfortable or even fearful by an autistic person's intelligence, or the way in which they express themselves with their gestures and their wordings, or at times, dissimilar interests. A lot of the time, this makes it harder for them to interact with us on an everyday level. What people sometimes forget is that everybody in this life has different ways of expressing themselves, whether it be through art, science, music, or even through building Lego sets. Nobody should degrade them for that by saying that it's not normal. It's just their own unique way of truly expressing how they feel about things in this world. It doesn't make it wrong. It's just different. Each person in this world is different from the other, and yet these so-called normal people have the tendency to degrade autistic people just for acting and expressing things in a different way from them.
Look around us. We have got so many different kinds of people here that are all cogs in the machine of society. We've got shop owners, entertainers, drivers, law enforcement officers, politicians. All are vital parts of the machine that keeps society going. Autism is a vital, crucial, understated, and subtle part of our society. But if you could change that, cure people with autism, then you'd be changing society as you knew it. And no matter how many people think that autism is a glitch in the system, nobody should have to think like that because, well, it just isn't fact.
I think as a parent with a child with autism, I think if most parents, if they weren't or being honest with themselves, if there was a magic wanderer pill that you could give your child to cure it, you would. You definitely would. Because the thing is that when a child is born different, it's not just the burden on the child, it also affects the family and the parents around, siblings, brothers, everything, sisters, they all get affected by the one individual. So life would be a lot easier for them and us if I could give that pill. But then again, if you have somebody with mild autism or Asperger's or something like that, I think that that's the choice of the individual. They make the choice.
No, I don't think it should be cured. I think people with autism bring a lot of difference to the world, diversity. If we were all the same, the world would be a very, very boring place to live in. So people with autism bring a much needed different perspective to the world, how they live their lives, to go about their daily business.
No autistic person should ever have to feel trapped by his or her condition, and they should never feel as though they have to adapt their behaviour for so-called normal people's sakes. Instead, they should exalt the aspects of their condition that make them feel powerful, strong, independent and unique.
You see, I like superheroes, both with comics, but mainly movies. And I often compare my autism with that of the X-Men, because they have extraordinary and unusual abilities that so-called normal people don't have. Because of that, the humans in that world treat the X-Men, who are also known as mutants, as something to be feared and not normal. Yet these gifts that these superheroes possess are wonderful and give them an advantage over normal humans. And I like to think that my autism is a gift, a power, as I can see things in a different way from others. Sometimes it gives me an advantage, sometimes it doesn't, but it allows me to operate in such a way that helps me deal with situations in my own way that helps me, whether it be unconventional or not. I don't want this gift ever taken away from me. Why should I? And if anyone doesn't expect it and has some kind of problem with that, well, I have no words.
Sometimes what people consider to be traditional or conventional forms of appreciation or admiration may not resonate or be interpreted in the same way by someone who has autism. Even just normal social pleasures, like being invited to parties, going out to the cinema, being asked to go on holiday, are all things that I would dearly like to do with other people and be involved in. Something that I should be able to offer up some sort of reason as to why these opportunities never come, and I do absolutely everything so I can be involved in them. But somehow, it's not quite right, or it's not enough when you have autism like I do. And it makes you wonder and overthink as to why, and I take it really personally. When one of my friends asked another one of their friends to go on holiday with them without considering me, or I'd like to go out to cinema with one of my friends and then choose someone else to go with, it's difficult to accept. All I ever wanted was to do these so-called normal social activities with my true friends, and it hurts when that doesn't happen. And in that scenario, I'm either going to rise above it or I'm going to fall.
I think severe autistic people will always need care and support, and I think it would be difficult for them to maintain independence in society. However, higher up in the spectrum, the high-functioning autistic people, most definitely, no question at all, that they can be independent, so long as they can be they can learn that what they need in terms of life skills, and will always need a bit of help and direction, so long as they've got someone to go to when they get into difficult situations or new situations that they've not come across before.
A lot of the time, I'm saying that a lot in this documentary. A lot of the time, autistic people, including myself and everyone else, need other people in their lives. My brother tells me that if others don't get the autistic part of me, then they're not worth my time. Yet again, the only thing I truly desire from people is for them to include me in more things. To see me as someone who doesn't have a condition, who doesn't think that my autism is a hindrance, to let me be in situations where I can be the one to help others, to be there for others, to care for others, to support others in my own unique way. Rather than it being the other way around, where I am not treated as a petty case, but as a person, the truly real person that I am, whilst at the same time not expecting me to be a normal person, just to treat me fairly. Because in reality, there is something that so-called normal people who judge me by my condition alone often don't realise. Normal? There is no such thing.
And thank God there isn't. Because the world would be an extremely boring and unchallenging place if everybody was normal.
normality does not create society. And when you look back over history, it's the ones that stood out and weren't normal that have made it and made the world what it is today. So normal is not a tick for me. The more quirky and wacky people out there making our world a better place, the more I'm for it. So the answer is no.
To describe like people as normal or whatnot, it almost doesn't quite make sense. Because, you know, it's a fact that everyone's mind works differently. Everything about everyone is different. So, you know, I think it comes down to like other subjects, like what media portrays as normal, what media portrays as what the norm is, what we should look like, what should be done, and how it should be done. So it comes down to what we're sort of told from a very young age through different platforms of filmmaking, music, and everything. But personally, I don't believe in being normal, and I think it should almost be promoted to be different, because it will give people a lot more confidence within themselves and a lot more sort of self-appreciation.
You know, Stephen Shaw, an autistic professor, once said, if you've met one person with autism, then you've met one person with autism. Not every person with autism is the same. Every single human being on this planet is different, autistic or not.
It isn't as simple as just putting a label on someone and then assuming all the cliches and all the stereotypical traits that come with it, therefore dictating the way in which they are treated. I deserve to be treated in just the same way as every other individual. Everyone is different. I'm just different with a label.
The main difference is the autistic people don't hold back. They say it as they feel it at the time, whereas normal people will just step back and think, actually, if I said this, is this going to hurt their feelings? With children with autism and adults with autism, they don't. They go straight in and say how it is.
I think the more we understand autistic people, more we will understand the thought processes and the in-depth knowledge that they have that many others do not. And I think it is a total waste not to embrace the talents and the attitude and paradigms that autistic people have.
Throughout my life, I have met many different kinds of people with their own different interests, different attitudes, different abilities, and even different conditions that makes each one stand out from everybody else. It is precisely because everyone is different. Nobody should have to be judgmental or afraid of any of them. To quote a great transforming robot, there is more to them than meets the eye. If I can leave you with anything from this documentary, I would like to leave you with a sense of understanding as to the condition of autism, and your understanding and perception of me. All I ever wanted from my friends in life is just a comforting sense of understanding, acceptance, and appreciation for who I really am, with a sense of unity as one of you. Because that's what I am. Over time, society has managed to educate itself to understand about racial, religions, gender, etc., and in turn, accepts those groups. I think it's now time for society to start to understand the value of the autistic group. I am not an alien. I am a human with his own unique differences. But that is a good thing. At least, that is how I perceive it. I could be wrong, but in actuality, there is no right or wrong. It's just about interpretation.